So in this series, every day we will be discussing one shloka of Bhagavad Gita. We will learn how to recite that shloka, and we will discuss the meaning of the shloka, and we will also discuss the application value. How are we supposed to apply this shloka in our own personal lives? So that would be the theme of the next 30 days. Every day in the morning, 15 minutes we will be doing this. So the format of this, as I said, is first 5 minutes we'll focus on recitation. So I will recite the shloka, and maybe I'll unmute a few participants to also recite, and I'll give more preference to children. So let them also recite. So like that, we will try to focus on the recitation. If you want to recite, you can also unmute yourself. So after 5 minutes of learning how to recite the shloka, then we will discuss the meaning of the shloka line by line for 5 more minutes. Then we will discuss how to apply that shloka in our life, and whole day you can meditate on that shloka, and I will also meditate on that shloka. So like that, in this 1 month, let us try to equip ourselves with the wonderful Gita wisdom that Krishna has given to us. It's our great fortune that every year we celebrate Gita Jayanti, and we get an opportunity to meditate on the wisdom of Gita. So shall we begin? Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Hare Krishna. So the shloka that I have chosen for today was from the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So as you know, in the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita, we saw that Arjuna was confused. He was bewildered about performing his own duty. Right? He had so many doubts and so many reservations in fighting with his own relatives. And he expressed all that confusion. And finally, he said, I cannot resolve this confusions on my own. I need to take shelter of a teacher, a guru. And he surrendered to Krishna. Fine. So let us recite this shloka. That's the context of this shloka. So, Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah prichhamitvam dharma sammoodha chetah yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam. So now let's get into recitation. Aradhya. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Prichhamitvam dharma sammoodha chetah.
Prichhamitvam dharma sammoodha chetah.
Yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Sri Ram. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetah.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetah.
Yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Thank you. Then who else will recite? Srishabhadev. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetah.
Prichhami tvam
dharma sammoodha chetah.
Dharma sammoodha chetah.
Yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yah shreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Sishyasteham shadhimam pram Prapannam.
Prapannam. Very good, very good. Thank you. Shubhangi. Karpanya dosho pahata swabhava.
Karpanya dosho pahata swabhava.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha cheta.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha cheta.
Yashreyasyanishchitam bruhitanme.
Yashreyasyanishchitam bruhitanme.
Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Thank you. Nikhil Gandhi. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham. Okay, he's not there. Then Prashasta. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaham.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaham.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yashreyasyanishchitam bruhitanme.
Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Thank you, Sundar Hari Prabhu.
Thank you.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavah.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetah.
Prichhami tvam dharma samudha chetaha.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
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 Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Shishyasteham sadhi mam tvam prapannam.
Sangeeta Mataji. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaham.
Prichhami tvam dharma sammoodha chetaham.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Yashreyasyan nishchitam bruhitanme.
Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Shishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam.
Thank you. So we will discuss the meaning of it. I understand there are so many devotees who would like to recite. So tomorrow you can recite. So now let's get into the meaning of this shloka. So this shloka is very important. Although there are so many important shlokas, I have selected 30 shlokas for this series. And this happens to be the first shloka in the series, mainly because this emphasizes the importance of accepting a guru. Arjuna was in confusion, and in such a confused state of mind, Arjuna approached a teacher, the supreme teacher, Krishna, right? So this shloka describes the importance of accepting a guru. Let us see. So we need to meditate on each shloka and each phrase or each word of the shloka. So when we break the shloka into small phrases or words and try to learn the meaning of individual phrases or words and then see the overall meaning of the shloka in one place, then it makes more sense. So it's not that shloka recitation and the translation are different. So we can relate the English with the Sanskrit nicely. And if we do it phrase by phrase or word by word, that becomes much easier. Let us see. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham. Karpanya dosha. Karpanya dosha means due to miserly weakness. Kripana means miser. Karpanya means being miserly. Dosha means it's fault, it's weakness. So Arjuna is saying that, my dear Krishna, I have this miserly weakness. What is this miserly weakness? When we are explaining the shloka, we'll come back to that. Okay. So, or let me say now, Karpanya dosha means, what does a miser do? Kripana is miser, right? What does a miser do? Miser may have a lot of wealth, but he doesn't utilize the wealth, isn't it? Similarly, Arjuna had a lot of strength as a Kshatriya, but he's unable to use that strength as a Kshatriya to fight with his opponents. That's the Karpanya dosha here. And in a deeper perspective, Arjuna had a lot of intelligence, but he's unable to utilize that intelligence to take proper action. That is the Karpanya Dosha here. Fine. So that is Karpanya Dosha. Apahata Swabhavaha. Apahata means he has lost composure completely. So because of miserly weakness, he's unable to act in a very coherent way, in an intelligent way. He has lost composure. Then third, Prichhamitvam, in such a confused state of mind, he's asking Krishna. Prichhami means I'm asking. Tvam means you. He's asking Krishna. In what state of mind? Dharma sammoodha chetaha. Dharma means your duty. Sammoodha means confusion, illusion. Chetaha means mind. So when my mind is filled with a lot of confusions about how to perform my duty, I'm asking you, Krishna. Because of miserly weakness, I have lost my composure. I have become so confused. So I'm approaching you. I'm asking you. And what is my expectation from you? Nishchitam bruhitanme. You should tell me for certain. Nishchitam means certainty. Bruhitanme means you please tell me. What should he tell? Yah shreyasyan. What is good for me? Shreya means what is good, what is auspicious. Please tell me what is good for me. And shishyaste aham. I have become your disciple now. Earlier, Arjuna was the friend of Krishna. Later, Arjuna became a warrior and Krishna became a chariot driver of Arjuna. Okay. So now, Krishna is not acting like a friend or a chariot driver. Krishna is supposed to act like guru now. Arjuna says, my dear Lord, I am not a warrior. I am not your friend. I am your disciple now. Please instruct me. Shadhi maam. Shadhi means instruct me, enlighten me. Tvam prapannam. I have surrendered to you. So that is surrender, means taking shelter. Shadhi maam tvam prapannam. So you understood the meaning of the shloka? Meaning is clear? So next, let us see what this shloka teaches us. How should we apply this shloka in our own lives? Rupa writes that this whole world is a place of perplexity or confusion. And because of this world which is filled with miseries and confusions and perplexities, oftentimes we won't be able to decide what is good and what is bad, what is right and what is wrong, which direction to go. So by taking shelter of a guru, by approaching a bona fide, knowledgeable and reliable teacher, we can come out of all confusions. Right? So the world is a place of confusion. And a human being can come out of that confusion with the help of a guru. And a guru is one who takes us on a journey from confusion to clarity. So on this first day, we are discussing how Arjuna is saying, dharma sammoodha chetaha. My mind is completely confused. Confused about what? To perform one's duty. I'm confused about my duty. What am I supposed to do? Arjuna knew it was his right to fight for the kingdom as a Kshatriya. But he did not know whether it was right to fight with his own relatives. Okay. He had right to fight, but he did not know whether it is right to fight with his own relatives. Okay. So Arjuna was confused. So to come out of the confusion, to get a clarity in mind, we should take shelter of Guru. And after hearing entire Bhagavad Gita, what did Arjuna say? Arjuna said, Nashto moha smritir labdha. Tatprasadan mayachyutan. Initially he said dharma sammodha chetaha before Krishna began his teachings. And after Krishna completed his teachings, he said that nashto moha, all my illusions are gone. So Bhagavad Gita is such a literature that takes us from confusion to clarity. If we take shelter of Guru, Krishna, bona fide Guru. We may say, okay, I don't have Krishna now to take shelter. Yes, Krishna is there personally in the form of the instructions of Bhagavad Gita. And Krishna is also there in the form of his representative guru. A guru or a bona fide teacher in a bona fide Vaishnava Sampradaya is a perfect representative of Krishna. And by taking shelter of such a guru, we can come out of all confusions in life. And this is the recommendation of all scriptures also. Now, who is Karpanya? I already mentioned a little bit. But one who does not use the opportunity of human life is a miser, Prabhupada says. So, who can take shelter of a guru? Only a human being can take shelter of a guru. Not non-human beings. Dog cannot go to a teacher. Or a cat cannot go to a teacher. Only human beings have the opportunity to go to a spiritual teacher, spiritual master, and submit oneself and learn from the teacher, right? So one who does not utilize this opportunity to take shelter of a guru and advance spiritually is a kripana, is a miser. So as a human being, he has more intelligence compared to lower beings, right? But he is not utilizing that greater intelligence, greater facility to take shelter of a guru. Such a person is called miser. So we should not be miserly, but we should be open to take advice of a more intelligent person, more spiritually advanced person, guru. Okay. The miser's problem is, Prabhupada says, he has skin disease. What is skin disease? Identifying oneself with body and identifying others also with their bodies and trying to connect with other people through body only. Okay, that bodily identification is skin disease. So we have skin relation with others and we also have soul relation with others. So soul relation is permanent, skin relation is temporary. Skin relation means like as soon as somebody enters a body, the person gets in some relationship with so many people, mother, father, brother, sister, many other relatives. All these relations are based on the body. But there is a relationship based on the soul, that is Krishna, with Krishna in the center. So we need to focus on that. Krishna is trying to bring that focus of Arjuna on the soul rather than the body. Arjuna was identifying with bodily relatives, but the first teaching that Krishna is going to give is the difference between body and soul. So to conclude, confusions are common, but an intelligent person knows what to do in confusion. We are confused. What are we supposed to do? We should approach a teacher, a small student, a third standard or fourth standard, confused in solving a mathematics problem. So you should go to a teacher, mother or father or a teacher, and tell me how to solve this. So that is real intelligence, right? So being confused is not wrong. But not to know what to do when I'm confused is something not expected from a human being, right? So an arrogant person tries to solve all of one's problems by one's own intelligence. If a small child is unable to solve an addition problem and trying to solve the problem on one's own without approaching the teacher, what will happen? Similarly, one who are not mature enough in spiritual life should not try to solve the problems on one's own. One should approach a person who is more spiritually advanced. That's the importance of approaching a guru. When the magnitude of our problem goes beyond the ability of our intelligence to solve, we should humbly approach a reliable guru for solution. And such humility is real intelligence. So that is the real intelligence. To have humility in approaching a guru and seeking that shelter and seeking that guidance is real intelligence. And we can effectively do so only when we have that humility and when we keep aside our own concocted conceptions. So Arjuna wished to listen from Krishna without opposing him. Because earlier also, in the second shloka only, Krishna said, where have this impotency come upon you? Arjuna, why are you saying I will not fight? And Krishna chastised Arjuna. You remember, second chapter, second and third shlokas, Krishna chastises Arjuna. Then Arjuna comes up with more arguments. Okay. Then Krishna says, Arjuna, when I am giving you advice, you are coming with more and more arguments. What is the use of my giving advice? Now Arjuna here says that, no, my dear Lord. Prichamitvam dharma sammoha cheta yaha shreyasyam nishchitam bruhitan me sishyasteham shadhimam tvam prapannam. I am not going to interrupt you as you are teaching. So I kept aside my own concocted conceptions and with a clear mind, I am surrendering to you. I am taking your shelter. I will not give any counter arguments. So when our glass is empty, somebody can pour in it. And the mind is filled with so many other thoughts and our own conceptions, Guru's instructions also will not benefit us. So we need to effectively take advantage of Guru's association. We need to go with a clean mind and clear mind. Of course, we have to understand with intelligence, but we should be open for learning new things. So we will conclude here. So before concluding, let's recite the shloka once again. Bankya Bihari Prabhu. Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham.
Karpanya doshopahata svabhavaham.
Namitvam dharma sammodha chetaham.
Prachyami tvam dharma sammoda cetaha.
यः श्रेयस्यान् निश्चितं ब्रूहितन्मे
यः श्रेयस्यान् निश्चितं ब्रूहितन्मे
शिष्यस्तेऽहं साधिमां त्वां प्रपन्नम्
शिष्यस्तेऽहं साधिमां त्वां प्रपन्नम्
I think I went a little beyond 15 minutes but we'll conclude for today tomorrow we'll come up with another shloka 2.14 thank you very much for your association Hare Krishna